So, what is up, guys? I am 63Z, and I am back, and I actually have a new mic.
Yes, it's gold.
But more importantly, this is actually to explain why I haven't been... This is more importantly to explain why I have not been fucking dead.
That. There we go.
Chair.
Into position, please.
I thought we talked about this chair. Anyway, so this video is more about why, like, I'm not tall enough at the moment.
It's because if I was to try to be tall enough... my motherfucking mic stand won't be able to keep up.
This video is more towards why I haven't been uploading. Now, I did say in the last video that I was in hospital. And yes, I was in hospital. This is going to be explaining everything of why. I'm not going to do it in two separate videos because there's no real point. Oh, I just whacked myself in the nuts. Oh, fuck. Anyway, so I was in hospital. The first reason why I stopped uploading, though, was because at the start of August, I had actually gotten a new girlfriend. Her name was Megan. We broke up at the start of September, just before I went into hospital, though. Probably because she poisoned me. But no, in all fact, it was because I wanted to try and give it the best go I could. And at the time, I wanted to get as much work done as I could as well. And I just didn't really have the time to do YouTube as well as have a relationship. So I tried to give it the best shot I could, which is fair on her and fair on me, because considering the situation, it was pretty fucked up. I couldn't just be like, nah, fuck you. We're done, like, straight away. I wanted to give it a good shot, otherwise I'd just feel like a jackass. I had done that for about a month and a half, something like that, and then we had broken up, but that was the main reason why at first I stopped doing YouTube. Well, not I stopped doing YouTube, I took that first little break from doing YouTube. So the next reason was because I went into hospital, and that happened on the...
pull up my fucking calendar.
I went into the hospital on... I went in on Monday the 12th. And it was like really late at night though, so I went in on Monday the 12th after I had seen a GP the day before because I'd woken up with bad neck pains, sensitive to light, all that kind of crap. And he said I should go to the hospital in case I have meningitis. If you don't know what meningitis is, it is a swelling of the brain, and that isn't a good thing to have, especially if you're, you know, want to live. I possibly had meningitis, so they sent me into the hospital to go see the doctors, obviously, get some checks, and instantly they admitted me. It was like an hour I had to wait, but you know, they admitted me basically straight away. And then it got to the point where I was starting to get a lot of pains, and at one point I was in like shooting pains. I was like crying because it hurt that much. And I was in there from the 12th to the late afternoon on the 15th. So I was in at the Lower McEwen for four days. Then they sent me home because on the Wednesday morning at like 3 or 4 in the morning, to make sure if I had meningitis, they had to do something called a lumbar puncture. And now a lumbar puncture is something that a pregnant lady would get, and it's also called an epidural. If you don't know what an epidural is, then you can look that shit up because But in short, it is literally a long ass fucking needle that goes between the vertebrae of the spine right into your spinal column to get liquid from obviously your spinal column, which is the liquid that your brain sits in, and it literally tells you if the bacteria in that area is fucked up. Motherfucking yes. Much fucking better. Okay, so where the fuck was that? So yeah, Wednesday night I had been given something known as a lumbar puncture. And that basically goes between the vertebrae of your spine to go right into your spinal column to get the fluid out of your spine, which essentially is what your brain sits in. It takes 3 days for those cultures to grow to show if you actually have it. They thought I had some type of meningitis, and there are three different types. Viral and three different stages of bacterial. The bacterial ones is where you can actually die from. The viral one is, you know, the best of the four options. The worst of the bacterial ones is 20% chance of dying, and 10% and 5%. So it's not a good chance. So after they had done the lumbar puncture on the Wednesday, they basically waited for me to finish. But they had a training chick do it. They had a training chick poke into my spine. A training chick poke into my spine.
Yeah.
Bruh. That's what I thought. She missed like a motherfucker. I had 6 holes in my spinal column. I was only meant to have one. I had 6 holes in my spinal column, and I had two extra holes in my back for general anesthetic. It took that long that they had to apply a second one. It felt like there was a lot of pressure building up in your back. It was just, ugh. But because they went through the lower back, which is where you're meant to do it from, It went through a lot of dense muscle tissue, which also meant it bruised my lower back as well. So not only did I have to wait for the spinal column to heal, I also had to wait for the muscles to heal, which were going to take a lot long. They were going to take a long time. But, you know, yeah. So it's been a month since it first started to happen. So then I had the Friday at home. I didn't have long because by the time of the afternoon, I spent Thursday night at home. I watched a movie. By the time it came to Friday afternoon, I had to go see the GP again to get a follow-up on it, and it just got so much worse. I couldn't even sit in the car without, like, breaking the floor in sweats. I was in there for, like, 10 seconds and it started to kill. Just sitting in this chair that saw it, actually, as well. Because it's going to take anywhere up from... It's going to take from 2 weeks to 2 years to fully heal. I should say it'd be around 2 months for me, but can't always be sure. Dad was like, nah, we're not taking you back to Long McKill. They already fucked up once. We're not going to let them fuck up again. So we had gone straight to the RAH, which is the best hospital in South Australia. Because there are a couple. There's women's and children's, but obviously I'm a child and a woman. There is the Flinders one, which is even further away, but it's not anywhere near as well rated as the RAH. And then there's the Long McKillen. There's other smaller hospitals as well as private hospitals, but those are the major four ones that people go to. Now, as I said, it would take a while for it to heal, but it was 2 days after, and I was trying to ride in a car, and it was a 30-minute drive into the city, so I could go to the RAH. And after 10 seconds, I was already in excruciating pain. I was like, you could get a squeegee, run it across my back, you'd have shots for days of my sweat. Of my fucking sweat. I had to go through that, and by the time I got to the hospital, I was just like, bitch, lie me on the floor. I don't want to sit in that chair and wait, lie me on the floor. I was in so much pain. They lied me next to a lady in a wheelchair. The lady in the wheelchair asked what the fuck was wrong with me. Don't ask what the fuck's wrong with me. You're in a wheelchair. You have it way worse than me. Don't worry about me. You're in a fucking wheelchair. I felt so bad. I was in so much pain, but I felt so bad that she was asking what was wrong with me because she was in a fucking wheelchair. But so I was there from Friday night, I was there through Saturday as well as through Sunday, and I came back Monday morning, which was the 19th. Now, annoyingly enough, my birthday was on that Saturday. It was the Saturday, the 17th of September. And on those days, when I was at the RH between the 16th and the 19th, I had YouTubers, I had streamers, I had a couple other people messaging me and tweeting at me and wishing me happy birthday. I didn't even fucking know the new me. Like, I knew Lieutenant Lickme near me because I've, like, talked to him before. I've talked to Clam Taco before. But all these people showed support to me. I was like, holy crap, I didn't know you knew me. And it was a great thing to have on my birthday, which is another main reason why I wanted to come back so soon. I was on severe bed rest for about a week. And that was like, I wasn't allowed to really leave my bed. The only time I was allowed to leave my bed was to go to the toilet and maybe to stretch my back a bit. Like, stand up, move around, then lie back down, essentially, straight away. They had me on cancer-grade laxatives. Cancer-grade laxatives. Take that in for a second. Yeah. Then I also had Endone for the pain, as well as something for nausea, and then something for vomiting. I thought they were the same thing, but apparently not. So I had like a concoction of different types of painkillers and tablets to take all for 2 weeks straight, and it's now been 3 weeks since I was off of severe bed rest. But instantly, as soon as I was out of severe bed rest, I actually went on a date, and that's who I'm dating now, actually, because I wanted to go on that date straight up. I did not want to miss that out, like 100%. Then I paid for that the next day because I decided to go back to work. 2 weeks after I had left the hospital, I didn't really want to take any more time off because I felt bad. I basically have been getting as much schoolwork as I could possibly do done, as I can possibly get done. So I am now literally on the last part of 10 more units, and I have 5 more to go. 5 more to go. So it's going to be a little while longer until I'm on a proper fucking upload schedule. Sorry for that. But I'm going to try and smash these out as much as possible because these ones are probably the more easier topics. Shut up. These are the more easier topics for me to do compared to the ones I was already doing for these ones, such as information knowledge management and fucking... Oh, so annoying. Anything to do with money, I'm fine with, so those topics are going to go fast. And improving team effectiveness, I'm fucking fine with that too. So those are basically the topics that are left for me. and I can get them done hopefully as fast as I possibly can, but that's still not going to be until hopefully the start of the year that I get these done by. But in saying that, I will be uploading again. This is the 13th of October today, and I'm hopefully going to have this edited tonight because my internet's out at the moment. I can't look at anything at the moment. So that's why I actually set up this mic, because it didn't work at first. I fucking found out how to make it work, and it works. I've had it for a week. I keep talking in the fucking viewfinder. I'm sorry.
Pooch.
Anyway, so that brings us to now. I'm still on occasion needing painkillers, and I'm no longer on laxatives and nauseas and vomiting and endone. I'm not on any of them now. On occasion, I'll need Nurofen and Panadol, and I am back to work. I'm actually back to the gym as of last week. We're going 2 times a week up until start of November. Then I'll be going back to 3 times a week. But I still won't be allowed to do anything that's majorly back, like lower back orientated. Because it can cause a bit too much stress. I'm not going to be able to do certain squats and all that kind of crap. So I'm trying to keep it myself intact. So I'm getting back into the fitness side of things, because I had, like, it was 3.5 weeks off of completely going to the gym. And I felt shit. Like, I literally felt shit. I'm back down to the weight I was before I went into hospital. So that's a plus. And things are kind of starting to look up for me a bit more now. I'm trying to get the hang of things again, because it's a lot to go back into. I only have a couple of videos to actually edit. I had so much less than I thought I did. I have my Avcon video. I have a G Fuel video, because I actually got my new G Fuel, the Blue Ice. I didn't do Blue Ice in that video. I did Tropical Rain and Coconut. The Coconut I never thought I'd do. I said that so many times in the video, so you'll be seeing that, as well as the Tropical Rain. I'll leave the surprises and shit like of what I said in that for that. I'm not going to give anything away. It was those two videos plus a actual normal vlog about being real. So that's all going to be done as soon as possible, because they're all vlogs. They're easy to do. The only one that will take the longest is the Avcon vlog, and that will be done last. But the other ones shouldn't take too long to do at all, including this one. Sorry if this is going to be a bit longer than normal. It should be about 13-ish minutes. Hopefully a bit less, if I can cut some of it out. But I just needed time to be able to get everything back in order again. And I know a lot of you will understand. I know some people have actually left since I had made that like little video a couple weeks ago. It's fine. I completely understand. I've unsubbed from people for less. I thank everyone who's actually stayed and who will be staying, because I've got a shit ton of games to play and a shit ton of ideas between me and you. I will be, after I finish this video, like editing it tonight, I'll be starting on the new graphics for the channel. So the Facebook page, the YouTube banner most likely, as well as a new intro. I'll be starting a new intro. I'll actually be recording how I made my intro, like a time lapse of how I actually made it. Most likely, if I know how to set it up with OBS. I've just got a lot going, and I don't really know what else to say. I'm sorry. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if any of this makes sense to you, leave a like. If you're supportive, leave a like. Thank you. But other than that, thank you guys for watching. Like and subscribe, and I'll see you all in the next video.
What? Oh my god!
We need back there. We need back there. It's just a game. I can do this. It's the easiest level. I can do this.
I hate how it glitches out.